any movie with Michael Fassbender, J.K. Simmons, and Rebecca Ferguson has to be great, right? Any movie based on a best-selling thriller has to be thrilling, right? You never name your main character Harry Hole, right? You shouldn't. All right, I've been Davies. This is my Real Rebel review of The Snowman. All right, so The Snowman is currently in theaters. It was made for about $30, $35 million, grossing a whopping $3.5 million at the box office. It was directed by Thomas Alfredson, who has been the director and at the helm of some great movies like Tinker, Tailor, Soldier, Spy, and Let the Right One In. So, what to say about this particular film of his, which, if you look at the reviews, I actually agree with. And this is one of the few times when you see critics and viewers alike agreeing on what they think about the movie. Rotten Tomatoes has this currently at 8% from critics and a whopping 21% from viewers. Huh. Spoilers ahead. So the story takes place in Norway. We follow Harry Hole. See, it's a washed up detective. Oh man, I'm a child. As he, this drunk, washed up detective has to solve this new mystery murder where this guy makes snow. Actually, it makes no sense. I can't even give you a plot line because it goes in so many weird directions. Normally, thrillers are so easy to follow. It's like every episode of Law and Order. There's a killer. We don't exactly know who it is. And it's like, it's tight and suspenseful. And then you find out at the very end, right? It should be very easy, except it was anything but. Now, my critic review of the film is going to be a 1 out of 5. I know that sounds pretty generous for what I've been saying about the movie, but I have to give it to Thomas Alfredson for at least shooting an aesthetically pleasing film. And Norway looks like the coldest place and most miserable place on Earth if you see this movie. But it is beautiful the way that he shot it. The camera moves are somewhat fascinating. You're like, oh, well, how did they actually pull that off? He took a lot of time to distract you with some great looking cinematography from the lack of plot, story, and thrills throughout it. Another big problem with this movie is the timelines. Like I said in one of my other reviews, it distracts from the viewers when you're caring about a certain people going through life and you flash back to some other completely random event and there's almost no connection. It distracts you from the plot line that you're trying to get to. And this movie does that several times, and in an already convoluted story, it makes it virtually impossible to follow. And I mean that in the full sense of the word. They did a good job of at least not tipping their hat of who the killer is by involving so many other characters that you think are going to be payoffs. You think there's going to be a great investment in because they spend like 15 to 20 minutes in each one of these side stories that lead to absolutely nowhere. There's no resolution. There's no purpose, it seems like, to any of these things. And as the audience, they don't even give you the reward of being like, all right, so this is what was going on. This is how they knew each other, yada, yada, yada. Nothing. It's slow and missing, and it makes more sense. Entertainment actually did an interview with the director who said he signed on late after Martin Scorsese, another great director, kind of backed out and went to an executive producing mode where he was executive producing the project. And he jumped into it and said he lost about 15 to 10% of the movie. He couldn't shoot the rest of it. They ran out of time, so he had to kind of cut this thing together. And maybe that's why it all didn't make so much sense, but man, did it just, I can't even explain when you're just waiting for these payoffs in it. And I could hear the audience around me being like, what? And then as they get to the end and then you realize you're not going to get anything from like the investment of 15 to 20 minutes in each one of these other characters, you don't get any payoff or any, you know, resolution, that you can just hear the breath leaving them. They're just like, it was unbelievable. Now, my viewer review is going to more come hand in hand with what we've kind of been talking about. I'm going to give it a 0 out of 5 for the viewers and anyone that just came to this movie to sit down and watch it, okay? You're not paying attention to the aesthetics or the style of it. Just like, I want to be entertained. I want to be on a thrill ride. It's a thriller, killer drama after all, right? You'd be wrong. One of the main reasons for this is the complete lack of character. You still have no idea who Michael Fassbender's Harry Hole character is. Like an hour into the movie. Like they never, you just know he's an alcoholic with a bunch of problems and you know nothing about his past. You hear that he was some big time great detective, but he's living in a town with no crime. And they established that too. And he's just bumbling around for no reason. Likewise, you think like Val Kilmer, when he pops on screen, I didn't know Val was in the movie. I'm like, oh, I love Val Kilmer. He's a fantastic actor. His character is almost like forced into the movie. And then, unfortunately, I think he had some like mouth problems, like he was dealing with something. And it isn't even his voice as his character. It's like dubbed over really weird, and his character just disappears. It's unbelievable. And the other girls in it are just like forced in there too. You don't find out a motivation for anyone, particularly the killer. Like, there's no, you never find out why it's a snowman. You never, like, it's, you never find out this is why he was doing it as like a snowman as the symbol. It's just like forced in there for no reason, and which is ridiculous because it starts out so campy and predictable in the beginning where it's like, this is the most stereotypical setup ever. And you're like, okay, well, at least we're going to have some payoff throughout the movie, right? No, it's like all the symbols they established, you never get to see them again. And then the rest of the movie is like overtly complicated when the setup for the main storyline was so easy. It was just, it was really bizarre. All right, as Faith, believe it or not, I'm going to give this movie a 1 out of 5. And the only reason I'm going to give it the clap for the 1 out of 5 is because Michael Fassbender's character is attempting throughout most of the story to be a father figure to a young teenager who he's dating, this teenager's mother, or had been, and he still wants to be there for him no matter what because he cares about him. He wants to be a father figure when everyone else wasn't. So I respect like the morals, the values of that, the responsibility of men to rise up and be the people they're called to be. Like, I can get on board with that, despite the rest of the movie completely normalizing the destruction of families and marriages, saying like, oh, it doesn't matter for people to like have affairs, end up with whoever they want to end up with, kids will be fine, yada yada. It's just, it's promulgating the same problem with the family and Western civilization we've had for years, which I didn't really like. But there's at least this one bright spot in it that we can kind of encourage and take away from. That's a stretch, maybe. I'm just looking for something, guys. And that's about all I can say about this movie. What? I can't even. I've been Davies with The Real Rebel Review.